My life was all about money and I was willing to sleep with men for money. But where I went after death, I brought neither my body nor my money. My body was there unable to move, yet I live my life satisfying the desire of the flesh, ignoring my soul that had become a wandering spirit. I rejected God in my life, but this very God I rejected came for me in the afterlife. Everything is vanity in this world, only our soul that matter. I died and found myself out of my body. I became a wandering spirit, unable to enter into contact with the living. Judgment was looming for I died in my sin, and despite my sin the Lord God came for me. The Lord began to show me the way I died. He said, "My daughter, before your death you were three, the spirit, the body and the soul. The spirit is me, the soul is you, and the body is just an envelope. The body you see sleeping there in your room is just an envelope. The true you is your soul. Brother, your body is not you. It is an envelope that allow you to touch the material world. When you die this body will return to dust. It is futile and vain." The Lord said to me, "Understand that when you can move and walk it's my spirit that move you." I said, "Lord, when we walk it's your spirit that animate us." He said, "Of course it's my spirit in you, but you don't love me. Therefore learn to love me, for my spirit is in you causing you to live. I live in you, but you always sadden me." I was saddened by all your evil action. When you wake up and stand on a new day to go to work, it's because of my strength. I said, "If that is the case, Lord, you are seeing everything I was doing." The Lord said, "Though I was in you, but in order to enter your heart I needed your permission. I was in you waiting for you to allow me to lead you. But you ended up leading me instead of me leading you. You were walking in disorder, stifling me." The Lord showed how I was going to hotel with men. Seeing these scenes I began to cry. I said, "Lord, why have you not stopped me?" And I did not know all this truth. The Lord said, "I do not force people in the world. You did not know these things because you never wanted to know. I have placed two ways for you, human, and I chose for you the right way, but you chose the wrong way, brother. I lived a life of fornication which affect the body, the soul and spirit, which is the Lord. That is why the Bible say, we should love the Lord with our heart, our thought and our strength. That way we won't sadden the Lord." The Lord said, "The reason people feel remorse is because of my spirit is saddened in them. People only regain peace after recognizing and correcting their way. My spirit always fight with men to cause them to renounce so that they will have peace. The Lord, men have no love. I came to save men because of love. I had no interest, but you don't love one another. I have prepared this eternal kingdom of heaven for men, but men have no love for me, and they are going to the place of torment." Then the Lord took me to where the poor live in hut. As they wake up in the morning they were saying in their heart, "Lord, have we come to the world to experience suffering? Do you really exist and do you even know us?" The Lord said, "Look at these people, I know them, and the most important thing I gave them is the breath of life, for may have sleep forever, like when you have were trying to wake up your dead body by yourself. But you have failed. These poor people are breathing but they are asking question. The issue is that people are in hurry but I do things according to my timing." I said, "Lord, I did not know these things, forgive me." The Lord said, "My daughter, your prayer for forgiveness is not reaching my ears because I am not the God of the dead, and you have died in your sins. I don't deal with the dead, but if the living pray for your soul I would hear them and save you. I cannot deal with you because I have no relationship with the deads." I said, "Please, Lord, give my mother a vision so that she would pray for me because she often have vision." The Lord said, "Even if I give the vision, she would not discern it, because I tried to speak to you Christian in dreams and vision but you are distracted. You don't discern my message. My daughter, you just need the prayer of the living for me to intervene and save you." I cried and said, "Lord, forgive me and give me a chance." The Lord said, "There is no forgiveness after death. It's those who are walking and living on the earth that are entitled to my forgiveness. When they confess I will forgive them. If they pray I will answer them. But I act in my own timing. People are in hurry and they want to manipulate me to do things quickly for them." I said, "Lord, my condition is difficult. I am suffering. I would not be able to bear it. Have mercy on my soul. I am hungry but I am unable to eat and I am thirsty. Yet my family is completely unaware of what I am going through. Please tell them not to come here, this is suffering." The Lord touched me on the shoulder and said, "I have loved you, but why have you rejected me?" The Lord was in tears for my soul that was lost. The Lord was calling me by my name. This is a loving God that is sweet. Despite the fact I died with my sin, His love was staggering. The Lord said I was always with you, but you ignored me, walking your own way. He was speaking with me in tenderness. The love that the Lord showed me, even my own father never showed me that love. I said, Lord, you are calling me by my name as if you have known me for very long time. The Lord say, I know every single man living in the world, and I know the number of the hair that is on the head of every man in the world. The Lord took me to pub and club where people were dancing profane music. The Lord said, these songs does not glorify me. Why were you dancing and singing these song? At that moment I tried to shout to these people to stop dancing these worldly song. I said, give up these types of life and stop hearing this music. You got to listen to me. If you don't believe, go check my body. I am dead. The Lord said, they won't hear you. I said, Lord, who are they gonna listen to? The Lord said, they would not listen to anybody. I said, I want to go and warn them. Then I got to the table where they were drinking in order to bring it down and scatter everything, but I was unable to touch any physical matter for my hand was grabbing empty space. Then the Lord took me to a place where people were quarreling. The Lord said, why do you quarrel? The world belonged to me. I have been asking you people to love one another. I tried to preach to the people, but they could not hear me. I became animated by a strong desire to proclaim the good news of the gospel to the living, but there was no contact between the living and the dead. I said, Lord, these people who are alive are not preaching the gospel. Please let me go and preach the good news to these sinner. But the Lord said, you are no longer alive, no one will listen to you. Then the Lord took me to a place to see musical celebrity preparing their son and concert. I saw how people venerated them. The Lord said, glory belong to me. No one will share glory with me, for glory is mine. I won't quote names of these musician, but they have to repent, otherwise they will have no place of rest beyond the grave. I said to the Lord, you don't want us to listen to profane song, what about Christian song? The Lord said, many of them do not belong to me. They have signed covenant with the other one, but they are using my name so that when my children will listen to their song, they will be weakened. These songs are not for my glory. I was stunned to discover that even those who sing for God also resort to occultism. I used to think that those who sing for God are good. They are singing for their own glory and not for my glory. They want to become famous and stars. The Lord took me to churches. I thought they were good, but the Lord said 85% of these churches do not belong to me. They are using my name to get money. I saw preachers on the pulpit, they were preaching and performing miracles, but the Lord said, I don't know them. I am asking leaders to preach repentance and to prepare the church. I am coming back any moment from now on. People are looking to the sky while I am in them. I walk with them and I am in them. Many of these leaders have resorted to occultism to perform miracle and draw the crowds for profit. Brother, I was a wandering spirit suffering of hunger and thirst, but I had no contact with the world of the living. And the Lord could not hear my prayer because He is not the God of the deads. Finally I saw my sister Naomi. She went to drop the kid to school and she was back home to get ready to go to work. I said, please Lord, get Naomi to my body, so that she would see that I am dead. Otherwise they will take me to the hospital that will declare me dead, and they will take my body to the mortuary. Please Lord, do something, don't abandon me. I want to get back in the body. I was sitting beside my body crying for my soul. I had such pity for my soul. I said, really, I died just like that. I did not even get what I was searching in life. I cried bitterly and said, Lord, since you have refused to answer my prayer, I accept my fate. I am waiting for people to notice my death. Life is vain. Everything is vanity. Today I see that God exists and He is real. I said, really, this body has deceived me. It is vanity. I did all thing for this body, but it will be taken to the mortuary and it will rot. Yet I gave it all, ignoring my soul. I began to preach to member of my family, exhorting them to love God and follow Him. The Lord said, you should have done that when you were alive. You are already dead and it's too late. I said, Lord, I know, but let me do it. I said, Lord, yesterday I was fine and in good health, but today I am dead. People would accuse my parent of killing me in a witchcraft sacrifice, for I was not sick. Have pity of my parent. You said you would come like a thief, and you came to take my life when I did not expect. please give me a chance. At that moment money was useless. What mattered was the breath of life, which is a big gift. I said, Lord, if you return me to life, all my life I promise to testify about you like a mad woman, and I will stay in your presence. I wish to be alive and be poor. I don't need wealth, for what counts is the breath of life, so that I can correct my mistake and prepare for the kingdom of God. The Lord said, I have prepared the kingdom of heaven for you, my children, but you are not entering. Behold, look. At that moment I saw a long table that went beyond the sight, and everything was ready on the table. The Lord said, all these countless empty chairs are for you, my children, but you don't love me and you are going to the other side. I said, people don't know this thing. Allow me to go back to warn the world about these things. The Lord said, even if you speak, they won't believe you. I said, Lord, just allow me to speak to them even if they would not listen to me. The Lord said, even you bring a dead man back to life in the cemetery, people are failing to repent. At that moment I began to talk to myself. I said, this pain is eternal, I am lost forever. I cried, while singing to the Lord. Finally the Lord held my spirit like a ball, and introduced me in my body. When I realized that I was in my body, I woke up and rose like a mad person, and I began to pray. When Naomi saw me praying, he thought I was crazy because she never saw me praying.